Hello and welcome to Rally Report at the end of this fourth day of the Lombard RAC, a day in which we've seen some superb driving in near ideal rallying conditions. The headlines this evening: Carlos Sainz and Pentti Arricola, the overnight leaders, have driven a blinder all day and are now only seconds apart. Malcolm Wilson has pushed his Astra to the very limit to hang on to his number 11 spot. Louise Aitken-Walker, having her best Lombard RAC for many a year, is in the top 20. The day started with five stages in southern Scotland. It ended with four in Kielder. We pick up the action in the Scottish Borders.
These are the classic Scottish stages, well known by the clubmen and the seasoned campaigners. But for Spaniard Carlos Sainz, it was his first chance to renew an acquaintance he first made on last year's rally. He wasn't a happy man. Arricola was pressing hard. His lead of a minute and a quarter had been reduced to just 33 seconds. In the four-wheel drive, four-wheel steering Mitsubishi, Pentti Arricola was on the attack. He set fastest times on each of the five Scottish stages. He had the advantage of having covered these same stages with pace notes in June on the Scottish Rally. It was very much foreign territory for Juha Kankkunen. Like Sainz, he hadn't been here since last year. He was disturbed by the long straights and blind brows, particularly difficult, he said, and you had no idea where the road went. Things just hadn't gone his way since he crossed the border. Brake problems too for Kenneth Eriksson in the other works Toyota. His service crew were preparing plastic guards for the brake pipes. No real problems though for Michael Sundstrom in the four-wheel drive Mazda, but he was worried about heading south. Last year, Dalby Forest was his downfall. Taking the air in Scotland, bruised and battered, Ari Vatanen was back on form with second fastest times to teammate Arricola. In another Mazda, 1985 world champion Timo Salonen, less than 5 minutes behind the leader in fifth place. Hannu Mikkola started the day behind Jimmy McRae and ended the Scottish stages almost a minute and a half ahead.
What were your times compared to Carlos on those stages?
We were quite 13 faster in the first one than Carlos. But Pentti is going really fast.
Yeah, I believe so. I think he's made some adjustment to his suspension, so he's going quicker.
I think so. Ah, but it's good.
Do you enjoy those, Hannu?
Yeah, those are very nice stages, you know, sweeping bends and a little bit faster. I like them very much.
Morning, Gwyneth. How's the race for the top Brit going?
Fair. We're dropping a little bit of time to Jimmy this morning, but not far. I believe Jimmy's on his own patch.
Yeah, well, you had your chance on the first day in Wales.
That's it,
Malcolm, I mean, you're catching on Malcolm Wilson now, aren't you?
We took a few off him on the last one, and it looks as if he's taken three or four off us on that one.
Good. So we're in for a good race of the Brits today.
Yeah, hopefully.
Malcolm, you were blowing off all the Sierras, the other Brits, for the last day or so. Are they catching you now, do I hear?
Yeah, they are this morning. It's the stages in sort of the Tweed Valley have been quite dry, so it's helped the causes somewhat. And they're very fast stages anyhow, so I think Jimmy's probably very, very close to us now. We know that Hannu's got in front of us, which was to be expected, but I think Jimmy's probably within 1 or 2 seconds of us now.
As the first Spaniard to lead this great British classic sped back into England and Kielder, Sainz was only too aware that he had a charging Arricola closing the gap, Toyota's Matador being chased by the bull in the Mitsubishi. After two circuits of Raw Hill and Reedsdale, Arricola had clocked up 9 out of 10 fastest times. His gallant suspension had been lowered for less oversteer, more traction and faster cornering. To try to avoid punctures on the badly cut up tracks the second time through, some very special Michelins had been fitted. On the rev limiter in top, Arricola was doing 130 miles an hour through the trees. Malcolm Wilson and his Vauxhall were winning three important rallies within the rally. He was driving the first car with only two-wheel drive. His was the first British car on the leaderboard, and at 11th overall, he was the leading British driver. Followed 2 minutes later by Gwyneth Evans, the leading Ford driver. And that was in spite of a total of four punctures and a bent suspension arm as the fourth day drew to a close. Jimmy McRae's Ford Sierra needed a new drive shaft, a change of differential, and two new wheels to get through Kielder. while Mark Lovell lost 15th place on the final stage of the day when he misjudged a left-hander and shot up a firebreak. He escaped, but it cost him 8.5 minutes.
So as the crews went off to their civic reception in Newcastle this evening, this is how the leaderboard looked. Sainz and Ricola, no doubt as high as kites on adrenaline, over 2 minutes ahead of Kankanen. Sundstrom and Vatanen have moved up one place, and Per Eklund is still there at number 8 in his Lancia. But it does look as if we're about to see our first ever Japanese winner for this event. Meanwhile, our peripatetic, to say the least, Mr. Mason, was waiting in Newcastle as the crews arrived.
Congratulations, Carlos. You kept your lead, but you've been under a lot of pressure from Penty today.
Yes, he was going very fast today. Very, very fast.
And you had a few problems earlier on.
We lost about 15 seconds in the first stage with the brakes problem, but now the car is okay and we will see what happens tomorrow. Anyway, tomorrow will be difficult.
Can't get him out. That was very exuberant. You're nearly pushing Carlos. You're in such a hurry to get past him. You're trying to push him off the ramp here.
We actually do in the same time, so I thought a bit of Finnish sportsmanship.
What a fantastic day, what a good drive.
Oh yes, it has been a very, not much pressure because it's not compulsory to do this business, but it's a fantastic to drive a rally car like this one, and so it has been a very enjoyable day.
And I needn't ask, what are the tactics for tomorrow?
No, I didn't come here to lose.
Well, there's a challenge indeed. That's all for today. The cars, of course, are back in Nottingham for the finish tomorrow. We are back tomorrow evening at 8:30 p.m. on BBC Two in our normal Top Gear slot with a special programme showing all the action of the day and giving all the highlights of the week. So see you then. Meanwhile, let's leave you this evening with some marvellous in-car footage of Penty Ricola burning up the gravel in Raw Hill in the Scottish Borders.